Hello, Fairless.
Today is Friday, November 2nd.
And this is Falcon Media.
On today's show we have
Seniors featuring Natalie Meek,
Spirit Week,
Falcon Feud,
Football Trivia,
Football,
Guess That Hawaiian Word,
Pets featuring Summer Patterson,
Cross Country Districts,
Band Goodbyes,
Ice Cream Social,
Factor Crap, Fairless Edition,
Smarter Than a Fifth Grader,
Guess That TV Show,
Yoga,
and Seniors featuring Natalie Meek.
What was your inspiration for this?
I was told to wear this.
Oh, you were told. I heard you really did not want to wear this outfit.
I did want to wear this outfit. It's really warm and comfy. Yeah, it's like wearing pajamas in school.
I'm a ass. Get it? That's why I'm wearing a Tuslaw costume.
What inspired your costumes?
Google.
How long did it take to make?
Well, it took me like 30 minutes, but Annabelle is a perfectionist, so it took her like an hour.
We got some chickens and dragons. What inspired your outfit?
Those were Brits. Walmart.
Walmart. Apple. Costume day.
All right, who's on your jersey?
Johnny Manziel. Yeah, he's in the Canadian Football League right now. His first game, in the first half, he threw 5 interceptions.
That's pretty bad.
Then he got benched.
Yeah, then he got benched. All right, who's on your guys' jersey?
This is the D. Rose right here.
Who's he play for now?
Minnesota,
not Cleveland.
Timberwolves.
Not Cleveland.
Right. Yeah, well, I couldn't afford that one.
How many times did he tear his ACL?
Twice. MCL twice.
Struggle here in D. Roseville. He seems to be coming back though.
Yeah. He's crossing up people nowadays.
Yep.
Don't be fooled. He's gonna tear it soon.
He's gonna tear his ACL again. His career's over.
Pretty much.
I'm wearing a Browns jersey. Number 80, Landry.
Wearing Jarvis Landry. She doesn't even know who that is.
It's my uncle's.
It's her uncle's.
One of a kind.
One of a kind. Jarvis Landry jersey. Who is on your jersey?
Kyrie Irving.
He doesn't play for Cleveland anymore. Who's he play for?
The Celtics.
Welcome to Falcon Feud with your host, Jared Six.
Hello, Fairless. Welcome back to Falcon Feud. Today we have Kelly and Evan. Each contestant will be given 25 seconds to answer 5 questions. The contestant with the most popular answers will receive the highest score and win the game. Okay, Kelly, time will start after I ask the first question. If you can't think of anything, just say pass, and I'll revisit the question if I have time. Are you ready?
Yeah.
25 seconds on the clock. Name a famous wizard.
The pass.
Today, Junior!
Name another word for book.
A reading thing.
What is the most stressful thing in the life of a 25-year-old woman?
Their job.
Name something you always have to keep plugged in.
Your TV.
Name a sport that some mothers hope their children never play.
Wrestling.
Name a famous wizard.
The guy from Wizard of Oz. What's he called?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Ah! Nice. Okay, Evan. Time will start after I ask the first question. If you can't think of anything, just say pass, and I'll revisit the question if I have time. Are you ready?
Ready.
25 seconds on the clock. Name a famous wizard.
Harry Potter.
Name another word for book.
Pass.
What is the most stressful thing in the life of a 25-year-old woman?
Job.
Name something you always have to keep plugged in.
Charger.
Name a sport some mothers hope their children never play.
Ballet.
Name another word for book.
Time.
Okay, Kelly and Evan, let's see how you did. The winner of this week's Falcon Feud is... Kelly!
No!
By how much?
She won by 4 points. With 67. I mean, to be fair, both of you didn't do too hot.
What? But Wizard of Oz was a great answer.
Yeah, you just...
Harry Potter was
You just failed
answer.
Less.
Yeah, he got the number one answer.
Guess who got the number one answer, Harry Potter?
Kelly Ooh, guess who won?
Alright.
Kelly got a number one answer, too.
Ooh, guess Which who one? Else got a number one answer?
Which she got TV it? And used a charger.
Ooh, who would... Why do you have to keep a charger plugged in all the time?
I don't know.
Well. See you next week on Falcon Media.
Falcon Media? Falcon Feud!
Falcon Feud! God bless.
On Friday, October 19th, the Falcons hosted Orrville in their 9th regular season game.
Guess that word, Hawaiian edition. Question 1. What does the word KK mean?
Animal.
Person.
Is it baby?
Animal.
Baby.
Answer C, baby. Question 2. What does the word lahanu mean?
Good afternoon.
Good morning.
Good afternoon.
Answer D, good afternoon. Question 3. What does the phrase Inanu Aki Ainamano mean?
Have a good weekend. Do you want to pet my dog?
Watch out for sharks.
Watch out for sharks.
Watch out for the sharks.
Answer A, watch out for sharks. Question 4. What does the phrase pahia u mean?
How are you?
Hey, bud.
Is it A?
Horse torx.
Absolutely. How are you?
Answer A, how are you? Question 5. What language are these questions in?
Hawaiian.
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 That's easy. It is Hawaiian.
Answer C, Hawaiian. And the winners are Mr. Schultz and Dr. Chambliss.
What kind of pets do you have?
I have 3 dogs and 2 fish tanks.
What are their names?
I have a bull mastiff whose name is Stella and 2 French bulldogs named Rhino and Annie.
Do you have names for your fishes?
No.
What's the funniest thing they do?
The French bulldogs make some really great noises. They like to snort, and when they snore, it's really an interesting noise.
What's your favorite memory with them?
Probably when Annie had her puppies. That's where we got Rhino, so, you know, they were really cute.
How long have you had them?
We had Annie for 12 years, Rhino for 10, and Stella for, like, 6.
Do you have a favorite?
I would probably say Annie because she's older, and I got her for Christmas.
Doesn't seem real. Then it catches up with you. It started to hit me around senior night, and that was pretty hard, because on our Friday practice, the rest of the band always surrounds the seniors and plays the fight song real loud, and it was finally our year, and I didn't know what to think. Some of us are crying, mostly me. It's hard. You wouldn't think it is, but it comes up and hits you. my last football game as a marching Falcon is this Friday. Not in a year, not in 2 years, in 2 days. It's fast. And I'm not ready to say goodbye.
Okay. So it's kind of like bittersweet because on one hand I'm like, oh my god, I'm a senior. Because at first it was kind of like, literally I don't want to leave this place because I'm terrified of my future, but I figured out what I want to do, so it's fine. But it's just kind of weird, like I've cried a lot. Like Bethany was saying, when like they surrounded us and like played the fight song, I was like sobbing. And I read like the letter that like Mrs. Barkin gives the seniors, all letters, and I read it and I was like mine, and I was like almost crying. It's like I finally have to go to college and this is gonna be my last time like going to a game and like marching band's over, and it's like, I don't know, it's kind of weird, like everything is really weird. And I'm sad about it, but also happy.
Well, the season, oh boy. I'm gonna miss it a lot. It was something that was always there. It was always something I could lean on for friends or support. In rough times, I would talk to my friends that I've made through Anstine and band. And I'm very lucky to have been intimated into Anstine, because if I didn't, I don't know where I would be. I've made so many friends along the way, and even in band, and I love everyone that I met. And it's hard to say goodbye to Barkin and Smith and Shannon, but I'm gonna have to because I have to leave. But I wish I wasn't leaving because I love them so much and I love everyone in the band. And I wish it wouldn't change, but life has to go on. So, yeah. I love Dance Slide and band. I love you, Mrs. Barkin.
It hasn't really hit me that band is over yet. Like, it hasn't really hit me that it's over. I don't think it's really going to hit me until it's like, and then my cap and gown downstairs saying goodbye to everyone on graduation. But it's been really nice just seeing everyone, especially this year with how many freshmen we have, everyone grow and how they've changed, not just as musicians, but as people just in the short 10 weeks and the plus for band camp. And I'm just really happy that I got to spend 4 years with these people. I mean, granted, it's a changing group of people, but I'm glad I got to spend it with them regardless, and they got to help me grow as a human and a musician in a lot of different ways, and I'll never forget that.
The Fairless High School Music Department presents the 2018 Falcon Marching Band in Concert. As the concert began, the Falcon Marching Band started out with some of their pregame songs, which included some drumline cadences, our very own fight song, the Star Spangled Banner, Long Train, and Get Ready for This. Next, the marching band performed their Life at Sea show, which included SpongeBob SquarePants, Pirates of the Caribbean, and Come Sail Away. Next, the band had their time show, which included 4 minutes, Good Time, and Time Warp. Following the time show was the band's homecoming show, which included Can't Turn You Loose, Louie Louie, and Grandioso. After that was their show titled All the Feels, which included Party Rock Anthem, Can't Stop the Feeling, and Walking on Sunshine. Every day I'm shuffling. Band's last show of the year was The Last Hurrah, which included the seniors on recorder for My Heart Will Go On, Good Riddance, Time of Your Life, Never Give You Up, Thanks for the Memories, and The Greatest Show. But never least, the band played some of Bride Weezer's favorite shorties, which included Let's Go Blue, Land of a Thousand Dances, Hey, Frankenstein, Iron Man, Godzilla, House, Nixon, Thunder, Phantom, Wild Thing, Seven Nation Army, First Down, FHS, and the Falcon Marching Band ended their evening of music with the Fairless alma mater and the fight song.
Fairless High School was built in 1972.
It's a false statement. 1964.
Crap.
Fact.
Fact.
Crap.
Fact.
Crap.
Crap, 1965.
Factor crap.
Before Fairless, there were three other schools.
It's facts right there. Straight facts.
Fact.
That
fact.
Is fact.
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 Crap.
Fact.
One in Beach City, one in Navarre, and one in Brewster.
Factor crap.
Fairless Middle and Elementary Schools were opened in 2007.
It's facts.
Fact.
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 Factor crap.
Benjamin Fairless's real name is Ben Williams.
Crap.
I should know that. I'm going to say crap.
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 Mm-hmm.
Fact.
He's Benjamin Fairless. I got the whole story about him if you ever want to know the whole history of him. Great, great story.
The winners are Logan Slutes, Mr. Boone, and Dr. Chambliss.
What country has the largest border to the U.S., Canada or Mexico?
Canada.
Correct. What country has the largest border to the U.S.? Canada? Correct. All right, boys. What country has the largest border to the U.S., Canada, or Mexico?
Mexico.
Incorrect.
Canada.
Correct. There you go.
What country has the largest border to the U.S.?
Canada or Mexico?
Canada.
Canada. That's wrong.
Are you serious?
No, that's right. It's not Canada.
Oh, you go. Canada!
Oh,
Canada.
I was going to say, how is it wrong?
What did the geologist study?
Earth.
Incorrect.
I don't know.
Rocks. What does a geologist study? Rocks, skeletons, or weather? Rocks. Correct. What does a geologist study? Rocks, skeletons, or weather?
Wait, what was the second? What was the second?
Rocks, skeletons, or weather?
Rocks.
Correct.
What does a geologist study? Rocks, skeletons, weather?
Rocks.
That's correct.
Whose picture is on the $5 bill? Abraham Lincoln, Andrew Jackson, or George Washington?
Abraham Lincoln.
Correct. Whose picture is on the $5 bill? Abraham Lincoln, Andrew Jackson, or George Washington?
Abraham Lincoln.
Correct. Whose picture is on the $5 bill? Abraham Lincoln, Andrew Jackson, or George Washington?
George Washington.
Incorrect.
Jackson.
Incorrect. It's Abraham Lincoln.
Whose picture is on the $5 bill? Abraham, Andrew, or George?
Abraham.
Lincoln.
How many months in a year have 31 days? 7, 6, or 3?
6.
Incorrect.
7.
Correct. How many months in a year have 31 days? 7, 6, or 3?
7.
Correct. Okay. How many months in a year have 31 days? 7, 6, or 3?
3.
Incorrect.
What? 6.
It's 7.
Okay.
How many months in a year have 31 days? 7, 6, or 3?
3.
7.
How many nickels are in $2? 40, 30, or 25?
40.
Correct. How many nickels are in $2? 40, 30, or 25?
40.
Correct. How many nickels are in $2? 40, 30, or 25?
25.
Incorrect.
40.
Correct.
How many nickels are in $2? 40, 30, 25?
25.
30!
That's also incorrect.
40!
It's
40. Oh my god!
Final scores: Carson 3, Colton 1, Amy 1, Bree 4, Jenna 1, Maddie 1, Zach 2, Justin 1.
Full house.
Full house.
Full house.
Full house.
Now this is a story all about how my life got flipped, turned upside down, and I'd like to take a minute, just sit right there. I'll tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel-Air.
Fresh Prince of Bel-Air.
Yeah. Fresh Prince of Bel-Air.
You say it.
Fresh Prince of Bel-Air.
Fresh Prince of Bel-Air.
Sweet Life
of Zach and Cody.
Sweet Life of Zach and Cody.
Sweet Life of Zach and Cody.
Sweet Life of Zach and Cody.
Prepare for something amazing.
Hey, my sis, what's up?
I want my mommy!
I will never forgive you! Larry!
Impractical Jokers.
Wow. Impractical Jokers.
Impractical Jokers.
Impractical Jokers.
That's all for today, Fairless.
See you next week on
Falcon Media.